So, hello friends, today I am going to explain Thomas algorithm for tridiagonal system. It is very useful for computational mathematics. So, what is the first question comes in mind? What is tridiagonal system? Because Thomas algorithm is applicable for tridiagonal system. What is tridiagonal system? If you have any matrix, then we have one principal diagonal and then upper diagonal and lower diagonal. If the given matrix having only three diagonal elements, principal, upper and lower. This is principal diagonal, this is upper diagonal and this is lower diagonal. Remaining all elements are zero. Then that system is known as principal tridiagonal system. So what is tridiagonal system? Principal diagonal is there, upper diagonal and lower diagonal is there. Then as usual, x1x, because this is 4 cross 4 matrix, so we have 4 unknowns and this is right hand side value, means of the form of ax is equal to b. But the only thing is, the given system is a tridiagonal system. So you understand, only three diagonal elements are there, remaining all elements are must be zero. Now we have tridiagonal system. Now what is I'm going to explain the methodology, how we calculate solve using a Thomas algorithm for this system. It's very easy if you know some basic steps. Only three steps are there. It is very similar to Gauss elimination method. So I'm going to explain one by one every step. So step one. Step one is, first you define the values. In which way? In which I am going to define. Principal diagonal, you denote by D. So what is D values? D values you write. What is D1? D1 means this is your principal diagonal. So 2.04. D2 is 2.04. D3 is 2.04. And D4 also 2.04. Understand? So first write D value. Means main diagonal you define by D, then the upper diagonal you define by A. What is A value? See, it will start from A1, A2, A3. Last is not there. So always, if it is a 4 cross 4 matrix, then definitely A4 will be 0. If it is a 3 cross 3 matrix, then A3 will be 0. If it is n cross n matrix, then an will be 0. So your a1 value is minus 1, a2 is minus 1, a3 minus 1, and because it's a 4 cross 4, so a4 always 0. It is very important. How it comes, I will explain in other videos. What is, and lower diagonal you define by b. B, for lower diagonal always first one, b1 value 0. Always you have to keep. Why, I will explain in next video. So what is and then B2, B3, B4. What is B2? Minus 1, B3 minus 1, B4 minus 1. And then R value. R value as usual 40.8, 0.8. Here we divide by R. 0.8. And this is 200.8. So this is first step, and which is very important. You have to define in this way, otherwise you will confuse. So always main diagonal you define by D, as usual D1, D2, D3, D4. All elements will be there, all entries. But for A, upper diagonal, always start from A1, A2, A3, and if it is 4 cross 4 matrix, then definitely last one will be 0. So which one 0? A4 0. and for lower diagonal the starting value will be always 0. So what is this is lower diagonal we denote by b. So what is b1 0, so b2 b3 b4, correct? Because this is one diagonal, this is second and this is third. So this is called tri-diagonal system. So hopefully you understand how we take the values of D, A, B, R. All values are very important. Once you know these all values in step 1, your step 2 is very easy. Step 2 is just like Gauss elimination method, or if you calculated rank anytime. So first the entry you have to make 1 and below that all 0. To make it 1, what we are doing? We are dividing the given row by this entry 2.04, means D1. So this is 1 and this is A1 is going to be replaced by minus 1 by 2.04, means A1 by D1. So what is A1 new value? It is A1 upon D1. And similarly, what is R1? It is R1 upon D1. See, always you have to take improved value. So what is your new A1 value? A1 upon D1. What is R1? R1 by D1. Same like Gauss elimination method. Always you have to go for improvement. Means always use improved value if you have. So once you calculated A1 and R1, step 3. For remaining value, means A2, A3, A4, R2, R3, R4, we have formula. What is the formula for AI? For AI, formula is AI upon BI minus BI AI minus 1. And what is the formula for RI? For RI, formula is RI minus AI RI minus BI RI minus 1 upon BI minus BI AI minus 1. This is your step 2. So just you have to put I value. Now step 4. Step 4. That is last step. Means here we are using Gauss elimination method. So we are going to use back substitution method. So back substitution means X4 is always equal to R4. And remaining Xi values we can calculate by the formula Xi minus AI Xi plus 1 RI minus AI Xi plus 1. So this much are the steps. First take the values, how we define D, A, B, R. Then calculate A1 and R1. Then for A2, A3, A4 value always 0. But for R2, R3, R4 you have to calculate by this formula. But only thing which you have to note down, you have to always use improved value if you have. And then step 4. R4 is always equal to X4. And remaining x1, x2, x3 we can calculate by xi is equal to ri minus ai xi plus 1. Now I am going to solve this question by this step. We have d, a, b, r, correct? So my first step is over. So step 2 for this question. What is A1? A1 is equal to A1 by D1. What is A1? A1 is minus 1. What is D1? D1 is 2.04. What is R1? R1 by D1. What is R1? R1 is 40.8. What is D1? 2.04. So simplify this and we get the value of A1. What is minus 0.49. And what is R1? R1 is 20. So this is your A1 and R1 improved value. So whenever A1 and R1 will come in step 3, we use these values. Now step 3 for this question. Step 3 means A1, R1 we have to calculate A2, A3, A4, R2, R3, R4. So now we are going to calculate A2. What is A2? Just put I value 2 here. So what we get? A2 upon D2 minus B2 A1. What is A2 value? A2 value is minus 1. What is D2 value? D2 value is 2.04. Minus what is B2? B2 is minus 1. Multiply it. A1. A1 which value we use? We not are going to use minus 1. We are going to improve value. What is improve value? Minus 0.49. So what is the final answer? Minus 1 upon 2.04 minus minus plus into minus minus 0.49. And when you simplify, you will get the answer. What is A2? So when you simplify, you will get the value minus 0.645. Don't think I'm fast as like a computer. Just I already solved this question, so I know the answer. So A2 is this one. Now we are going to calculate D2 value. So for D2, I will put here. So D2 value is R2. Sorry. Because A2 we calculate, now we are going to calculate R2. What is R2? R2 is R2 minus B2 R1 upon D2 minus B2 A1. What is R2 value? R2 value is 0.8. What is B2 value? B2 value is minus 1. What is R1 value? R1 we are going to use improved value because we have R1. What is that? 20 upon D2 minus B2 A1. Same this one. 2.04 minus 0.49, same value. So when you simplify, you will get R2 value. When you simplify, you will get 13.419. So now we have A2, R2. Now we are going to calculate A3. Now A3 is what? Just put I value 3. So A3 is A3 upon D3 minus B3 A2. What is A3 value? A3 value is minus 1. What is D3 value? D3 value 2.04. What is B3 value? Minus 1. A2 already we have improved value. And what is that? Minus 0.645. When you simplify, you will get A3 value as A3 value is, so you will get the values 0.716. Now we are going to calculate R3 value. What is R3? Just put I value 3. So R3 is R3 minus B3 R2 upon d3 minus d3 a2. What is r3 value? r3 value is 0.8. What is b3 value? Minus 1. What is r2 value? r2 improved value is 13.419. Upon d3, it is same 2.04 minus 0.645. When you simplify, you will get the value of R, and that value is 10.192. So now we have A3 and R3. Now we are going to calculate last values. Last value means A4 and R4. So A4, because already I told in the starting A4 value is 0, and you can check by the method. If you take A4, so A4 will become, and what is A4? 0. So A4 input value is 0 only. What is R4? R4 is R4 minus B4 R3 upon B4 minus B4 A3. Now put the values. What is R4? R4 is 200.8. What is B4? B4 is minus 1. What is R3? R3 input value is 10.192 divided by, what is D4? D4 is 2.04 minus B4. B4 is minus 1. What is A3? A3 input value we have here, minus will be there, minus 0.716. So when you simplify, you will get the answer. What is the answer? And answer is 159.309. This is 309 or 349. Please check it again. So you can do it. So now we have all values. Can we write, can I erase this all and we write all values first? So step 3 is over. We have A1 value is minus 0.49. R1 is 20. A2 is minus 0.645. R2 is 13.419. A3 value is minus 0.716. R3 value is 10.192. A5 value is 0. And R4 value is 159.309. Please check it again. So now we have A1, A2, A3, A4, R1, R2, R3, R4. All values we calculated. It means over. Now we are going to enter for third step. What is the last step? Last step means fourth. So now solution time. Using back substitution. What is X4? X4 is equal to R4. And what is R4? R4 is 159.309. What is X3? After X4, X3 will come. X3 means I value 3. R3 minus A3 X4. So what is R3? R3 is 10.192. What is A3? Minus 0.716. What is X4? X4 is 159.309. When you simplify, you get some value 124 point something. So do it. What is X2? Now X2 value. X2 value is, we just put I value 2. So it is R2 minus A2 X3. So what is R2? R2 is 13.419. What is A2? Minus 0.645. one is Xc, 124.21. So when you simplify, you will get the value 93.586 at that time. Please check it. Now what is X1? X1 is R1 minus A1 X2. Just put the values. R1 means 20, A1 means minus 0.49, and X2 means 93.586. So whatever, you will get some value. So now you have X1, X2, X3 and X4 values. So this is the complete procedure for Thomas algorithm. Now again I will revise, I will give the brief for what I did. Whatever system given, if it is in tri-diagonal system, because whenever they ask solve by Thomas algorithm, definitely the given system is in tri-diagonal system. So once you have tri-diagonal system, denote main diagonal by D, upper diagonal by A, and lower diagonal by B. Just one thing you have to remember, upper diagonal starts from A1, A2, A3, and so on. But last value always 0. And when you go for lower diagonal, starting value always 0. Means B1 is always 0, and then B2, B3, B4, and so on. Just you write the values and then write R values, whatever right hand side is there. Once you written, your first step is over, which is just to write the values of D, A, B and R. Once you written, then just go for step 2. Step 2 means just use the formula for calculating AI and RI. Two simple formula I written, and you, I think you note it down, and please learn it. Once you have AI and RI formula, just put the values and remember one thing. Before that we have to do A1 and D1 value, R1 value, improve. What is A1? A1 by D1. And what is R1? R1 by D1. Then you go for step 3. Step 3 is what? Step 3 is just use the formula, what I told earlier. So once you have that one, it means you calculated A2, A3, A4, R2, R3, R4. But always remember, like Gauss-Seidel method, always use input value. Because A1 and R1, you have input value, so always use that one. If you don't have input value, then use previous values, whatever you have latest one. Once you have A2, A3, R4, A4, R2, R3, R4, just use formula for Xi. Xi formula is very simple, Ri minus Ai Xi plus 1. So just calculate. R4 is equal to X4 always. Whatever R4 you calculate, that is your X4 values. Remaining value X3, X2, X1. Please don't forget the order, because it's a batch substitution method. So first you have to calculate X4, then X3, then X2, then X1. Once you calculate it all, it's over. So hopefully you understand the things. In next video I will explain why, how we written the formula and how we convert in tri-diagonal system. So hopefully you understand. Please share and subscribe this one. Please share among your friends. Okay, thank you.